Well, Kip from Wildlife Encounters is pretty darn good at scaring people. He almost had me put my fingers in an alligator's mouth on live TV the first time I met him. Yeah. I should have known.
No kidding. Well, you remember the skunk prank he pulled on me a couple years ago, right?
Oh, yeah. How can we all forget that? Incident? So what does he have up his sleeve today? I'm a little nervous, folks. Kip Smith from Wildlife Encounters.
Is he Kip? Yes. Happy Halloween.
Yes, he is.
I know. Thanks for dressing up.
I know. You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you.
No, but in fairness, you have all these animals. It was hard. You couldn't do a costume.
I have that big inflatable T-Rex costume, and I was going to wear it today, but I just didn't know how that would work with animals. Yeah. I don't know if that would work too well. Might freak some of them out a little, so we didn't do that.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good idea. You'd have snakes attacking you.
We need more problems on the set when you come in here. Okay?
Yep.
So what do you think? What did you bring in today?
It's Halloween, so we brought some kind of scary ones. We brought a cute one as well, but we'll get started.
Creepy crawly
this
things.
This is probably the animal that a lot of people have tons of fear.
There you go. I knew it.
But they're one of my favorites. They're really, really cool.
It's kind of pretty.
Yeah. Do you want to hold them?
They are. Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah. Good you question. Can hold them.
So that's a tarantula.
This is a tarantula. Yep. This is a rose hair tarantula.
I feel better having gloves on than my real skin.
Right. It's a rose hair, and they call him that because he kind of has those pinkish colored hairs on his body.
Yeah.
The males can live about 4 or 5 years. Females about 30 years. 20 and over, easy for these guys.
What is it about tarantulas that people don't like? Are they deadly? They're not.
They're not deadly.
They're not deadly. Not like some of the other.
No, not like
spiders.
Venomous snakes or anything like that. There's never been a death, from my knowledge, for a human from a tarantula bite.
Yeah.
They're venomous. He has fangs. Yeah. I can show them to you. I can pick them up. They're really cool. Here,
can we see the fangs?
Where's his eyes, by the way?
Right up top.
He's got like nice little soft.
Do they have personalities?
No, they don't have. I don't think they have personalities.
Okay.
Can you see those?
There you go.
There you are. Does that work?
Let's see. It's hard to see.
Are we looking at the fangs?
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
Oh,
I see him.
So interesting.
Two little fangs there. Here, stay there. This will be easy.
Okay.
Put them on your head.
I imagine it hurts too when they bite.
I've been bit a couple times. It's not that bad.
Oh, it's not.
It just feels like a bee sting. This guy's really friendly though.
I wouldn't be able to feel it through this.
No. we had one that was really aggressive that would bite you, but these guys, they're super nice. Even in the wild, you can pick them up.
Well, what's
really
worse?
Good.
Like, you got those brown recluse spiders?
Those are bad.
Those are bad.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. Those guys bite you. It kind of breaks down your cells, so you'll get like a hole in your leg or something like that. They bite you. These guys, you're totally fine. They're actually less venomous than a bee.
Yeah.
Bees are far more venomous than us humans.
It's really pretty. I'm kind of surprised.
But if people that don't like spiders see one of those, they freak out.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we get it all the time. People run away. We had one kid that, we didn't know this. He had arachnophobia, and he actually went in the corner and cried in the corner.
Oh.
And I had no idea.
You don't know.
Yeah, we didn't know. And then, he had to leave. But yeah.
Talking about spiders.
But really
here
important to us, though. Really cool. Oh, yeah, here's another one.
So we go from arachnophobia.
Mikey loves these guys.
So one question we get a lot.
I've had one of those around my neck before.
You want to introduce your partner here?
Oh, yeah, this is Ashley Smith, my sister.
It's her sister.
She's going to help us. This is Noodle that we've got here. He's now Bino Red Tail, and this is just your normal
Looks
red
like
tail.
Noodles.
So, yeah, you can hold him if you want.
Of course.
We're wrapping around.
Mike, you want to hold one?
No,
We're
just hanging out with you. So, yeah, same
like
type of snake, it's just Noodle
here,
is now albino. This guy's just your typical color that you'd see. So the albinos are not able to survive
in
the wild.
He's tightening, Kip, he's tightening. I can feel him clenching.
Another leash.
They won't hurt, yeah.
Here's my question, how long do snakes generally live?
So these guys can live 20 plus years.
20 plus years.
Yep. So it just depends on the type of snake.
Look at the, he's wrapping around my torso here, Kip.
Yeah, he'll just hang on. He just wants to make sure he doesn't fall. Remember, these guys are arboreal, so they like to climb up trees. So he'll hang on to you.
And they're restrictors too, aren't they?
They're constrictors, so he'll bite and squeeze.
Oh, good, because I think he's working his way around my neck.
Oh, no, he's just hanging out with you.
Okay.
And he'll move around. You can just let him climb around.
His head is down here by my arm.
I don't know, where is that? Oh, there he is.
Yeah.
There you go. Yeah, no, he'll just slither around. You can let these guys loose.
Oh, yeah, he's getting a little tight there.
Yeah, they get tight, right?
But you can see his tongue. He's sticking his tongue out, just smelling you, seeing what's going on in his area. They don't have eyelids. Really cool. So they actually shed the skin right off their eye.
Okay.
Look at this guy, Jake.
Yeah, here, you can even wrap him around you.
Yeah.
He won't do anything
to you.
Let's
do it. Okay.
See?
Why not?
So even just like that. He'll
just a snake necklace. Mine's all the way around my neck.
Yeah, I see that. Okay. This is fun, Kip. Happy Halloween, everyone.
They can't climb, so you can set them on the table like this.
No, they're good. They're fine.
They can actually slither around pretty well.
I think he likes me.
So that one was Noodle. What was this one's name?
This is Bethany.
Why Bethany? That's such a sweet little name.
We don't know. We didn't name her.
You didn't? Okay.
Someone had her as a pet, and they named her Bethany.
I like it. The pumpkins are going, but that's okay.
Will he stay on there the whole rest of the show?
It kind of just depends on where he feels like going.
That's cool. Yeah. That's cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, they'll just learn.
Our next friends from Morrison Gardens will love that, I'm sure.
we'll have to put him back for our next animal because these would eat our next animal.
Oh, okay. Let's do that. Let's put these back and grab the next animal.
These guys. Okay. You can keep the snake on you if you want, though. Here, you want to grab these guys? Do you want to keep the snake?
Further constrict me.
Do you want to keep the snake?
No.
He
does, not with the fox.
Hey, that's your first time having a snake on your neck, though, isn't it?
No, I've done it before.
You have? Okay.
Good job. Good job, buddy.
No, here, we'll set him down.
Those are good for Halloween.
We'll just hang
out. Thanks for bringing those in, Kip.
Yes.
So where do they come from?
These come from South America, Central America, and Mexico. You find these animals. So a rainforest animal that we find.
They are kind of pretty.
They're really cool.
No, they're gorgeous
animals. Their colors are gorgeous.
I am
so excited, and I promise I will not skin this animal for its fur.
Oh, gee, girl.
That's like Cruella.
Cruella DeVille quote. Yeah.
Please, PETA, don't call me. I didn't mean that.
I'm just going to wash the snake, but it's on the ground.
Yeah.
These are fennec foxes. Mm-hmm. So we find these guys in Africa.
Gosh. Is that a baby?
No, full grown. Full size. Yep, this is Oscar. Ashley's going to grab our other fox, Mia.
I want one of those.
They're social animals, so we have two of these
guys
together.
Can you have them as pets?
This one, the next one, Mia, was actually someone's pet. She had it out in western Nebraska. Do you want to have her hole here?
Mikey, look, they have leashes too.
They do have leashes.
This doesn't really work.
That one doesn't work? All right. We'll just do it. There you go.
And this
and
is
you can
Mia?
Hold her. That's Mia, yep. And just hold her real close to you.
Oh, what a
just
dog.
Like that.
I
so just
feel,
sit with
I don't have gloves on, so I want to feel on. What she feels
so
like.
So, do you, I mean, can you have them as pets?
Some places are legal, some places they aren't. Here in Omaha, these would be illegal, so you can't have them here.
But outside the city limits, you could?
It depends. You have to check your laws.
Check
with
your
the
local,
animal laws,
yeah.
You check your city, state, county, and then your federal
do
law.
Do they make
as well.
Good pets, though?
These guys, for the ordinary person, no, I wouldn't recommend it. There's people on YouTube that have these as pets, and they'll show videos. They don't show kind of, with animals, we don't show the bad side sometimes. So, they're cute animals, they're really cool, but generally, they're really hyper at nighttime. Yeah. They smell. They go to the bathroom a lot. They dig a lot, too. So if you had one in your home, maybe it would just be constant digging all the time for these guys.
And then at some point, the owners get fed up with it, and then they release them, or they have to get rid of them somewhere.
You don't want to release these guys. They wouldn't be able to survive here in Nebraska. They would die. You know, they have a nice 75, 80-degree temperature where they like to be at.
We're running out of time, but remind our viewers, how can we book you for parties, corporate events, birthdays? How do we get a hold of you?
They can check out our website, wildlifeencounters.org. We're on Facebook, Instagram, all
you
that
go
good
to schools
stuff.
A lot,
yeah, we
right?
Go to schools, yeah.
Is it basically whoever wants you to come, you'll come out there for any kind of event?
Where people want to learn about animals, we can visit. About 90% of where we do our schools. We do educational programs for schools and libraries. Summer reading programs are coming up with Omaha Public Library, so we'll be doing that soon.
Yeah,
as
I think you've been in both of my kids' schools and their daycare. You go to a lot of daycares as well.
I might have you come to my birthday party. I think it's so cool. I'm serious.
We've done that before for adults.
For adults? I've got why not?
Like, yeah, there's the birthday guy, and there's like a 40-year-old guy. He's like, it's me. I'm happy I didn't scare
this
thanks for
little
coming.
Guy.
Ashley, thanks a lot for coming.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Happy Halloween, okay?
Happy
good
Halloween.
To see you.
Take that snake with you.
It's still
here.
Just don't forget that thing.
He's just hanging out. Nope.
All right. Guess in the morning. Bless our day with coffee from Paris.